Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar and in this video, we are going to set up domain name or path based routing with ingress controller on Kubernetes cluster environment. Let's begin. In previous video, we installed Nginx ingress controller on Kubernetes cluster environment. Daemon service is running for ingress controller with two ports. Let's create a domain name based routing for a hotel project. I have created a YAML file for end-to-end project. I am creating a separate namespace for this project called hotel. This portion of YAML file describes the ingress controller configuration. For the hotel project, we are creating a ingress object and this object is available under beta 1 API version. This is the simple metadata of this object. We are creating the ingress rule for the URL hotel.example.com so that end user can access hotel application on the URL hotel.example.com on port 80. This rule is going to listen on HTTP protocol. We are creating this rule for the root of the project and we configure the backend service so that ingress controller can forward the traffic on this service and port 80. This is the service of the project where ingress controller is forwarding the traffic or request for the URL hotel.example.com. This is the deployment part of the application with two replica set and we are using a image from Nginx in our project. I am not going to be explain this deployment file end to end because we are more focusing on ingress controller. Let's go ahead and deploy this project on Kubernetes cluster environment. It has been completed. Let's verify. It created a separate name server with name hotel. Two ports are running. One service is running. Since we didn't configure the load balancer yet, hence external IP is blank and we configure this service on host port 80. These are deployment and replica set of this project. Let's go ahead and describe the ingress object of this project. This project has one ingress controller. Let's describe it. This is the default backend for this ingress object. This ingress object has rules on hotel.example.com and these are backend service. And two containers are running, 85 or 91. Let me explain how it is going to work. Suppose that I am end user of this application. I will browse this application by using the URL hotel.example.com. Then ingress controller accept the request on port 80 and ingress controller will look at the rule of this particular object. If there is no host or URL is configured, then ingress controller is going to forward the traffic on default backend, that is 404 page. If the ingress controller find the host name or DNS hotel.example.com, then ingress controller is going to forward the traffic on these two containers or ports. These are event of ingress controller object. That is good. We don't have any error. Let's get a detail of ports of this project. Ports are running on worker 01 and worker 02. Since we are not using the load balancer, hence you need to point out hotel.example.com on one of the worker node. For the testing, I created a host entry for hotel.example.com in the local host file and pointing out on one of the node. It is correctly pointing on one of my worker machine. Let's try to access this URL on the browser. Yes, we successfully able to access the application on port 80. Requests are getting served from 91, that is worker 2 machine. This is the URI, that means requests are getting served from root level. Let's take one more example for path-based routing. I have created a complete YAML file for path-based routing. I'm creating a separate namespace for this project called cafe. This is the ingress object for path-based routing. I am creating a rule for the virtual host or DNS of this project cafe.example.com and creating a path-based rule for tea and coffee. If a user browse the application cafe.example.com/tea, then ingress controller is going to send a traffic on tea service. Similar way, ingress controller will forward all the traffic for the coffee URL path to the coffee service. These services are configured here. This service for the tea and this is the service for coffee. And this is the deployment object for the coffee and this is the deployment object for T. These are very generic information for the deployment file. I'll create a separate video how to write a end-to-end deployment file for a project. Let's go ahead and deploy this file. Okay, it has been completed. A new namespace created for this project called Cafe. 5 ports or containers are running for this project. 2 deployment and replica set is running for this project. Let's get a list of the ingress object in this namespace. 1 ingress object is running. Let's describe this ingress object. This ingress has default backend also. Cafe.example.com URL is configured under the rules section and tea and coffee configured for path-based routing on these containers. These are events and they are clean. Ports are running across worker machine in Kubernetes cluster environment. Now you need to point cafe.example.com to one of the worker machine. So you can see here cafe.example.com is pointing on worker 1 machine in my Kubernetes cluster environment. Let's verify it. Okay, now we can try to access path-based routing for the cafe application. Excellent. We can able to access path-based routing cafe.example.com/t and response are coming from one of the pod. This is the URI. Let's try to access another URL, that's coffee. Excellent, it is also working fine. Response are coming from one of the coffee pod on the coffee URI or URL. So that's a complete demonstration how can you set up a domain name or path-based routing with ingress controller on Kubernetes environment. In this way you can run multiple virtual host or DNS on same port. Let's look at some of the troubleshooting step. For example, we set up the ingress rule for the hotel project and we are getting the 404 not found page on our requested URL. It means that we haven't correctly configured the host name or URL in YAML file. Let's look at here. Hosts are empty. Hence, ingress controller is forwarding all the requests for the unknown host to the default backend service. Let's go ahead and configure the correct host name here. Go ahead and redeploy the file. Now try to access the application once again. Yes, now it is correctly responding on the requested URL. Suppose that you are getting 502 bad gateway message on your requested URL. Let's troubleshoot. It means that ingress controller is listening on the correct host or domain name, but request or traffic are not routing on correct backend service. Let's examine our deployment file. In the deployment file, we are routing the traffic on port 8081, whereas hotel service is running on port 80. Go ahead and correct the redeploy the file. Try once again. Yes, it started working. You can use this basic knowledge to set up the ingress controller in your Kubernetes environment. In this video, that's all. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Goodbye.